Hello everyone, welcome to Achievers IAS classes. Let's begin a discussion on the current events of 15th Feb 2019. The first issue in news is regarding the division of powers between the Delhi government and the central government, which was argued for in the Supreme Court. The argument was over six contentious issues on the division of powers between the Delhi government and the centre, which is represented by the LG of Delhi. The Supreme Court ruled that the Delhi government has the power with respect to the appointment of special public prosecutors, the power to deal with electricity commission or the board, and also fixing the land revenue rate. But the court ruled that the LG has the authority over the anti-corruption branch of Delhi, and the Delhi government cannot exercise control over central government employees. On the issue of control over service matters, that is the transfer and posting of officers in the Delhi, Andaman and Nicobar Island Civil Services cadre, the two judges of the bench gave a differing opinion and therefore have referred the matter to a larger bench of the Supreme Court. The next issue in news is regarding an analysis done by the Center for Science and Environment, which has said that nearly half of India's waste to energy plants, which are meant to convert the non-biodegradable waste to energy, are now defunct. Since 1987, around 15 waste to energy plants have been set up across the country, but 7 of them have been shut down, for which the key reasons are the lack of segregation of solid waste and the high cost of electricity generated by these plants, which is unattractive to power companies. This is because the quality and composition of the waste has low calorific value and high moisture content in India, which is complicated by the fact that there is lack of segregation of waste, thereby requiring additional fuel to run these plants, which increases their cost of operation. Also, there have been protests against these plants for polluting the environment, and the National Green Tribunal had also slapped a fine of Rs. 25 lakh on one of these plants. Given the plan put forth by the Niti Aayog as part of the Swachh Bharat mission to generate around 800 megawatt of electricity from these waste to energy plants, the analysis done by the CAC has proposed the setting up of a Waste to Energy Corporation of India, which would construct incineration plants through PPP models in order to make them attractive. On that note, let's move on to the next issue, which is regarding the CAG report on the Rafale deal. The Rafale deal had resulted in various accusations against the government over the price, the deviation in procurement policy, and also the delivering time frame of these aircraft. The CAG report says that the present deal works out to be 2.86% less expensive than the previous deal, and the time frame has been advanced by 1 month for the delivery of this aircraft. Therefore, it states that the price advantage is less than the 9% claimed by the government, but it does not explain other doubts related to the deal. Like for instance, it states that Dassault Aviation made gains due to the absence of a bank guarantee, which was not passed on to the Indian government, but it does not quantify this amount, thereby leaving the doubts unaddressed. Next, on the issue of India-specific enhancements, the report states that there is a 17% saving, which has to be further examined given the high final price of the aircraft. The other issues that Dassault was not the lowest bidder in the earlier process and its technical bid had been rejected up to 6 times should also be explained further. And finally, the report questions the defense acquisition processes in place, citing the delays over the acquisition of defense equipment like radars and also the Chinook helicopters, which have taken unduly long time, thereby demanding a systemic overhaul. The final issue in news today is regarding the cowardly attack of the terrorists against the CRPF personnel in Jammu, killing at least 37 personnel. The attack raises the questions over the security on the national highway, which is patrolled by three agencies, namely the local police, the CRPF and the army, on a daily basis. The Jaish-e-Mohammed has claimed the responsibility of the attack, and the Indian government has blamed Pakistan as responsible for the attack by this terrorist organization led by international terrorist Masood Azhar. The militant outfit has been said to regrouping its strength, and the attack has come at a time when the security forces have carried out operations killing more than 20 militants belonging to the Lashkar-e-Taiba and the Hizbul Mujahideen outfits. We'll further look into this issue based on the findings of the NSA, which will be visiting the site and find out if any security loopholes resulted in this attack. On that note, I'm wrapping up today's news analysis. Do like, share and comment to support this initiative. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.